Hi, I'm Karen from the Belfast Women's Crew, and today we're outside the doors of the A&E at the Mater Hospital in North Belfast. There's a protest taking place where the people are calling for more provisions for mental health patients who walk in the doors of the A&E. Let's ask some of the protesters why they're here today.
I'm here in support of suicide awareness because 2009 I had to cut my brother and find my brother hanging in his own loft. So, and my younger brother's tried to commit suicide 3 or 4 times. Every time he comes to the Mater Hospital, they keep turning him away and he goes home and tries it again. They send him home with diazepam and tablets. So the worst thing to give somebody who's trying to do it himself in is tablets. They're going to do it even more.
Basically here to try and make people realise how serious suicide is, particularly in Belfast. It seems to be that the likes of the Mater Hospital here, where we're outside, really don't understand how many people are taking their lives when they turn them away from the door.
What would you say to the staff of the Mater Hospital who'd have to deal with people who come in after attempting to kill themselves?
Basically, I would ask them to put their policies and procedures into practice, because I'm sure they're not. You know, I'm not knocking the health service in any way, but there's procedures there, and I just get the impression they're not being followed. I mean, there's a card to leave, and I'm aware of at least 2 young lads from East Belfast that have came across, and they didn't get the card to leave and leaving the hospital. And just be more current, you know, because this sort of thing could happen to anybody. I mean, we're standing here now and there could be somebody yards away from us who's either contemplating or has taken their life.
During the day, I work with young people from 11 to 18, and I lost my own son 2 years ago when he took his own life. And during the week, last Tuesday night, I arrived at this hospital with my other son at 21. And we wanted him detained with his own GP and the bailed-up GP. And both me, as being a vulnerable adult, I have the permission to put him in. And this hospital, although it says care in that building back there, they didn't show any care at all. They just sent him out with 4 diazepam.
This is not just a health issue on its own. There needs to be a departmental approach to the whole issue of mental health, suicide and self-harm. We can't just lay this on the health department and say it's all your problem, away you go now to deal with it. All the other departments have a role to play in this. And if we look at how they dealt with the same issue in terms of road death or traffic accidents, where they all work together to bring the road death total down to the lowest ever. I think it was 54 or 55 people died last year on the roads. And yet there was 314 people died by suicide. If that had been the other way around, and it had been 314 people down on the roads, there would have been such an outcry. And the community, the public, would have been shouting from the high heavens, and rightly so. And what we're saying is, there needs to be the same urgency. There needs to be the same funding and commitment into the area of mental health and suicide to bring that down, because we know we can't bring it down. But they all need to work together. That's the key to this. But the key also is working together in their departments, but working with the community in a partnership that is worthwhile.